Hello students, I'm Shalini Sharma, present here for Shalini English classes. I hope you all are doing good and staying safe at your home. So here I am with the very first lesson of English textbook Flamingo for class 12. Before I initiate lesson, I would like to remind all of you, don't forget to like and subscribe my YouTube channel. I hope you all would be liking and subscribing it. Okay students, let's start with our today's lesson. That is the last lesson. Ironically, the first lesson of your textbook is the last lesson. Now, let's read something about the author. Alphonse Daudet. Alphonse Daudet is a well-known writer, a French novelist and a short story writer, and he is known to have written stories with a charming mixture of humor and sentiment. Now the last lesson is one of his best stories, in which he shows the change in France's fortunes through the eyes of a young boy from the border regions of Alsace. The story is set against the Franco-Prussian War and France's defeat. This lesson somewhere renders a touching impact to the identity of the French people who were being deprived not only of their political freedom but also of their language. Now the theme of the lesson is basically all about language chauvinism and its importance to the citizens of a country. So let's read about it, let's learn about it, what's there in a lesson. So in the very first paragraph, you will come to know about a young boy, Franz, who is going to school and as usual late for the school. He was afraid of facing his French teacher Am Hamel, who had set them the task of learning participles. Why? Because the teacher actually had told students that next day would be a test of participles, but he was not prepared. Franz was least interested in French grammar and hadn't learnt the participles. He was more interested in the birds chirping in the woods and Prussian soldiers drilling at the beck of the sawmill. Resisting the temptation to bunk school, ultimately he hurries off towards it. Then the second paragraph somewhere talks about how he is going towards the school. On his way, he saw a crowd at the town hall reading a bulletin board. Now, why this bulletin board is important? Remember, somewhere one important question comes from this paragraph. Why bulletin board was important? So, all the bad news, lost battles, the draft and the orders of the commanding officers were printed there. So that time, Franz wondered why they all have gathered right now. Then what he saw there, a blacksmith was standing. The blacksmith watcher who was reading the bulletin astounded him by his remark, because he was listening what Franz was saying. So he told him he needn't hurry, there was plenty of time to reach school. Actually, that blacksmith was knowing what has happened. Franz was somewhere thinking, what's happening? So he just avoided that thought and left for school. Now in next paragraph, you will see Franz reached school, and at school he was further astonished by the lack of any noise, hustle and bustle, desk opening and closing and teacher's ruler tapping on the table, which was a general scenario. But today it was all missing. It was as quiet as a Sunday morning. Frank's classmates were already sitting in their places, and M. Hamel was walking up and down with his frightening iron ruler. Who is M. Hamel? Yes, M. Hamel, the French teacher. Now, this boy friend thought that M. Hamel would be angry with him. Embarrassed and frightened, another shock awaited him. He was not knowing that M. Hamel is going through something. When he entered the class, M. Hamel asked him kindly to come in and sit down because he was about to start the lesson. Now somewhere, when Franz looked at M. Hamel, he got in more conviction and thinking power that some problem is there. Franz sat down hurriedly and noticed that the teacher was dressed in his best Sunday clothes. Sunday clothes here means those clothes which he used to wear only on the inspection days and prize days. M. Hamel was wearing a beautiful green coat, embroidered black silk cap, which he wore, I told you, only on inspection and prize days. He was further shocked to notice that all the back benches were occupied by the elderly village folk. He was still in dilemma what's going on, and at that time a thunderstorm kind of thing happened. He was wondering, and at that time M. Hamel said something. M. Hamel made a startling revelation. And what was that revelation? Orders had come from Berlin to teach only German in the schools of Alsace and Lorraine. And it was going to be their last lesson in French. And then further he added that next day onwards, a new teacher would be joining. Now this was a thunder clap for everyone. Everyone was thunderstruck. What happened? And that time, Franz had this thing in his mind that why he wasted his time. When he had time, he could have studied. But that time, what he used to think? I have enough of time. He felt a sense of regret that he had not learned French and wasted his time. All the books of grammar and history that were headache earlier looked very attractive to him now. He felt deep pain that M. Hamel was going and forgot how he hated his ruler and his cranky nature. Realization strikes him that M. Hamel was wearing his best clothes, the reason because it was his last class, and also understood why all old men of the village were sitting there. It was for showing gratitude and respect for the 40 years of faithful service that M. Hamel had put in. So somewhere, all these things made him realize his mistake. So students, till page number 4, I have explained you the summary of the lesson. I have explained you the meaning of every paragraph. Now, the remaining content will be explained to you in my next video of this lesson, which will be titled as The Last Lesson, Part 2. So, please listen this instruction carefully and don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Thank you everyone. Have a nice day.